This is our language diagram, mainly developed by, you know, Noam Chomsky, and we are here. See, I always you try to remember this grammar. This is what is grammar? This is the finite state machine. You can see it is a right linear grammar because you have variable at the right, and this is a context free grammar. This is a to the power n, b to the power n, and you can see with example 0, 1 or a, b. You should be, say, here it is 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, and you see the only the start variable can go to epsilon, okay. And this is context sensitive, and with these rules, you can go to the a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n. These rules you can, a little bit you can remember. One funny rule is this a0 and 0a, so that you can change it. These are the rules you can, you apply it, you can get this. This is context-free grammar, so it will be more complex, okay, this you all know. We are more interested in the context-free grammar, and moreover you see the Chomsky's normal form. Chomsky, you know, that's a famous Noam Chomsky, and he said that there's any context-free grammar. What I have said, the definition of the context-free grammar, we only said the left-hand side only single variable, right-hand side can be anything, okay. And but Chomsky said, okay, that's good, that rule may be legible, understandable for human being, but ultimately all these rules have to be checked by a computer, you know, your programming languages, the rule has to be checked by a parser, and first you have to check by whether it is okay or not, and then is a parser. First is a lexical analyzer, we check by a deterministic finite state machine only. They gets a token put into a symbol table, then the parser. Parser is nothing but a machine with a push-down automata Turing machine, and it checks whether the parsing is a one and only unique parsing tree. Okay. So, for there, the rules, if you have written the all context-free grammar, it can be shown, it can be written this way. Left-hand side a single variable, right-hand side only two variable or a single terminal. Have you got it? So any context, and it can be proven that any context-free grammar, left-hand side a variable and right-hand side any strings of terminals and variables in any order, or a and must be all variable ultimately must be terminated by a terminal. That is always that kind of, that is called single rule. That must be there, and these rules, a to the power b, c, small a and all this, these all these rules can be converted to a Chomsky's type rule. This is called Chomsky's normal form. Why it is normal? So it looks decent. So what is the advantage of it? Whenever the rule left hand side 1 and right hand side 2, it can be easily understood by our, say, our if then else structure in the program, or our computer is nothing but binary, yes, no. So the computer can understand. So this is the rule. A context-free grammar is in Chomsky's normal form. If every rule is of the form this, and where A is the terminal, yes, this is only the terminal, A, B, C are variables, except that B or C may not be the start variable, okay. In addition, we permit is, yeah, that is very good. We always say that only the start variable, if A is the start variable, it can go to every epsilon, no other variable. So this is the Chomsky's normal form. Why it is required? Because most of your computer generated thing we have to convert. So there is another normal form, it's called Grybek normal form, we'll cover it. So this is a bedrock of context-free grammar, both deterministic context-free grammar, non-deterministic context-free grammar, that is the Chomsky's normal form. And now we have to convert any grammar to Chomsky's normal form. Let's see. Today we can cover it or not. Why the structure? This is, yeah, the same thing. I have taken it from another book just to show you the which are the different ways. Ultimately, if it is start variable, they just A is start. If it is start, it can go only to epsilon. No other variable can go to epsilon. Why I am putting to epsilon? Because if you want to accommodate a blank in your language, then you put it. Otherwise, no. With this, I wish to end. Normal form of context-free grammar, I have taken to Hopcroft Brook. You please see this. I have taken it there. So, same thing is material is told. Chomsky's number form. It is very important. Let's see the next slide. Yeah, here you can see this advantage. So, a variable, and it looks like a binary tree. Whenever you see in a binary tree, that is very easy for computer to understand. So, that is the reason all the nodes have two child or one child or no child. That is the great thing of the Chomsky's number form. Okay. With this, I wish to end today's lecture. Why this is Chomsky's number form is single variable, either two child or only one child as a terminal or no child. So, you can put all these rules in such a way, so you can parsing and everything will be much easier. So, generally taking the Ohmica's question that programming language not only deterministic context free grammar, but it will always try to have a Chomsky's equivalent form so that computer can generate parsing in quicker time, because whenever you put your grammar in like this kind of binary tree, it is not a binary search, it is a binary tree. Why it is a binary tree? There is no relation, say this is a lower value or this is higher value. This is a binary tree. It has two nodes, or it can have only one node with a terminal, or it cannot have, no, it might not have node here. But whenever it is fully parsed, it should be lower, all should be your terminals should be there. So, terminals is a sentence and upper part of your parsing tree. Okay, that should be the unique.